Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's talk about some of the recent updates on the Google Play Developer Console. Now, if you develop Android apps and have apps on Google Play, you may have gotten an email from the Google Play Developer Console last week with changes to their policy updates. Now, we get these every so often. They'll make certain changes, they'll send things out. For the most part, I just ignore them, right? But, you know, but this time it was actually pretty interesting. First of all, I don't know if you guys get this, but every time I get an email from Google Play Developer, part of me just sort of, you know, it just goes, oh my God, like my heart stops for a second, right? Because if you've ever gotten an email that says your app has been suspended or temporarily suspended or your ad mob has been stopped for whatever reason, you know, part of you just, it goes into, you know, disaster mode, right? And that's happened to me just a few times, but enough so that every time I see the email from Google Play, you know, part of me just sort of shrinks, right? Even though I haven't done anything wrong, right? And I think I would be the same, like, if the police were knocking at the door. Like, if I looked through the curtain and saw the police were, knocking at the front door, part of me would sort of freak out, even though, you know, logically, I haven't committed any crime. It's just sort of like that. So, anyway, so once I got over that little bit of shock that Google's emailing and say, oh, it's just a policy update, I read through it, and it was actually pretty interesting, but it was very much like an Apple thing. So if you look at that email, they talk about, you know, they made some changes to the base guidelines and things like that. But, you know, some of these links are really interesting. First of all, they have a bit more, you know, guidance here on spam and minimum functionality. And so it says here on the, if you go through that page, it says, we don't allow apps that spam users or Google Play, such as apps that send users unsolicited messages, which makes sense, or apps that are duplicative and low quality. Now, that low quality thing sounds a little bit subjective, a lot like Apple is, but I don't think we're gonna have as much trouble with it like we do with Apple. In fact, when I saw this spam area on the new on the policy updates, the first thing I thought was, oh no, it's just gonna be like having to go through that process again and the nightmare that we're having at the moment with Apple and the stuff that we had in the past, trying to make sure that it's not low quality, but it's also trying to make sure that, yeah, like it's that subjective nature of it. So make sure that it's good enough for an application. I mean, it makes sense from a user's point of view. I don't know how they're going to police that, but, you know, some of these other things here are a bit interesting. You know, sort of like message spam. Like, you shouldn't be able to send out, you know, SMS or email without the user's knowledge. That makes perfect sense. I mean, none of this stuff is really, you know, worries me. This wizard spam area here, there's a section here on wizard spam saying, you know, we don't apps that are created by an automated tool to be submitted to Google Play by the operator on behalf of other persons. So if you have like an automated tool, like say Appy Pie or Business, Biz Apps or whatever, right? Those kind of things should go on your client's, you know, Google Play platform, on their own Google Play accounts and not on your own. So, you know, all this kind of stuff. And it really makes sense that it shouldn't really affect, I mean, for me, it's not going to affect me too much because it's something I insist my clients do anyway, is set up their own Google Play accounts, set up their own iTunes accounts. So, and the other thing over here, there's another tab here for minimum functionality, which is really, it's hardly anything. It's just, it really just says, you know, common violations, apps that don't install, apps that install but don't load, and apps that load but are not responsive. So, yeah, for me, the thing that that I need to look in is the ANR request. So one of my apps has, it's not a high amount of ANRs, but it's about 2.5% of users get ANRs on EarSpy. And the reason, and I looked through it, trying to find out what's causing that. And it's really because we're checking the App Store and validating purchases. It's just one of these things, we need to make sure the internet's online and all that kind of stuff. So little stuff like that. But it's really interesting, if you haven't looked at this, it's so easy to ignore these emails, is to have a look at it and to see what's going on. I'm a bit concerned about the spam stuff, just sort of the broad terms that's being used, just because of, you know, like with the App Store, with the Apple App Store, it's always, you know, if you get a good reviewer, you're okay. If you get a bad reviewer, you're not. It's very subjective. But with Google Play, you know, it seems to be, you know, I think it's a lot more automated, so hopefully we'll be treated much more fairly. But anyway, I just wanted to bring that to your guys' attention. If you haven't seen it, it's, you know, very interesting and all that stuff. So anyway, that's it for today. Also, let me just, I'm going to try to get in the habit of saying this each episode. Don't forget to like and subscribe and all that, and comment and all this stuff. Anyway, that's it for today. That's it for this week, and I'll talk to you guys on Monday.